You're on board the news track. High drama unfolded at the CBI office in Kolkata after the arrest of TMC netas in connection with the Narda sting case. Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee camped at the CBI headquarters for close to 6 hours, daring the investigating agency to arrest her. Outside, TMC supporters resorted to stone pelting.
The Bengal political saga isn't over. A new chapter has kicked off. DD versus CBI. And again, violence peaked in this latest showdown as TMC workers resorted to stone pelting outside the CBI office.
पुलिस बाहर है, सेंट्रल फोर्सेस भीतर हैं, पथराव हो रहा है और कोशिश हो रही है किसी तरह रोका जाए, लेकिन स्थिति अभी भी पूरी तरह से शांत यहां पर नहीं दिख रही है।
A furious Mamata was also seen storming into the CBI office in Kolkata. But what has angered TMC so much?
क्या चाहते हैं तुम लोग?
Please,
अभी आया, खाली क्या बोलेगा, क्या बोलेगा? पूछो, पूछो।
Three senior leaders of the TMC, Minister Firad Hakim, Minister Subrata Mukherjee, MLA Madan Mitra and former Minister Sovan Chatterjee have been arrested in the case, and this has angered the TMC.
It is an illegal, thoroughly illegal arrest. It is a governor's personal vindictiveness. BJP is here to hire a guy.
ये तो पॉलिटिकल बायस टेस नाउ पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन इज गोइंग ऑन राज्यपाल तो टोटली इज वर्किंग एज मैन ऑफ बीजेपी
The Bengal governor, meanwhile, has condemned the violence in Kolkata. This even as TMC has questioned how the governor has given his nod and the speaker wasn't consulted by CBI. The BJP, meanwhile, has dismissed the charge of political vendetta, citing the serious charges of graft against the TMC netas.
निश्चित रूप से CBI सबूतों के आधार पर या पूछताछ के आधार पर उनको ले गई होगी और पूछताछ में अगर वो दोषी होंगे तो उनको जेल जाना पड़ेगा नहीं दोषी होंगे तो CBI जबरदस्ती उनको नहीं रखेगी छोड़ देगी
But even the whistleblower of the mega Narada scam has questioned why the BJP leaders like Shuvendu Adhikari have been spared by the CBI.
This is actually the fighting against the corruption. Anyway, finally they arrested. Why Shuvendu Adhikari? What happened to him? He also received the money from him, from me, and it was recorded and handed over to CBI. What happened to him?
The Legislative Assembly Speaker Biman Banerjee clearly told India Today early morning that the arrests are unconstitutional because to arrest MLAs or legislators, a permission has to be taken from the Speaker, which was not done in this case, as he pointed out. With camera person Tapan, this is Suryavni Roy for India Today, Kolkata.
The DRDO today rolled out its anti-COVID drug 2DG, developed in collaboration with Dr. Reddy's. 2DG can reduce oxygen dependence in moderate to severe COVID-19 patients. Is this the wonder drug that India has been waiting for?
India has added another arsenal in its fight against coronavirus. The first batch of the 2DG, or the drug known as 2-deoxy-D-glucose, the drug known to reduce oxygen dependency in hospitalized COVID-19 cases, was unveiled.
आज के दिन जो ये नई दवा 2DG के नाम से देश के लिए उपलब्ध कराई जा रही है डॉक्टर रेड्डीज लैब ऑलरेडी वैक्सीन के फ्रंट पर भी महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभा रहा है और कोविड के खिलाफ हमारी लड़ाई में उस जंग में हमको और मजबूती प्रदान करेगी
कोविड में विशेष रूप से यह ड्रग बहुत ही अपनी प्रभावी भूमिका का निर्वाह करेगी आशा और उम्मीद की एक नई किरण लेकर आया हम कोविड पर विजय प्राप्त करेंगे इस संकल्प के साथ हम सबको आगे बढ़ते रहने की आवश्यकता है
The drug developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization in collaboration with Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology, Hyderabad and Dr. Reddy's for treatment of COVID-19 was approved by the Drugs Controller General of India on May 8th for emergency use in moderate to severe cases of COVID-19. Clinical trials results show that the drug helps in faster recovery by settling in the virus-infected cells and preventing virus growth by stopping its synthesis and energy production. The drug is prescribed to be taken orally, dissolved in water. Hospitals will begin to receive supplies of the drug. To start with, nearly 10,000 doses will be supplied to various hospitals in Delhi.
DCGI ने अप्रूवल दे दिया है एमरजेंसी यूज एडजुवेंट थेरेपी. सो ये अभी पिछले 10-15 दिन से जो हमारे पास था वो कहीं हॉस्पिटल्स में डॉक्टर का प्रिस्क्रिप्शन के ऊपर भी दे रहे थे. अच्छा सा रिकवरी है पेशेंट्स में, जल्दी से रिकवर हो रहा था. ऑक्सीजन का डिपेंडेंसी बहुत कम था.
Drug manufacturers claim that the drug will be effective against all variants of the SARS-CoV-2 virus currently circulating in India. The second wave saw higher dependency in moderate to severe cases of COVID-19 effectively. The use of 2DG drug could begin to provide some relief and reduce stay in hospital for COVID patients. Bureau Report, India Today.
This is where I wrap up the news track tonight. Our thoughts and prayers are with those who find themselves in the eye of the storm. In fact, as I end the show, I want to show you the latest pictures from these satellite images about where the cyclone is just at this moment. As we hit 9 p.m., these are live satellite pictures. This is where the cyclone is, and I can scroll forward to show you what will happen in some time. So from 9 p.m., the next images I have for 10, it comes closer to the coast. Then before 11, it hits landfall. It makes landfall near Una. You can see the cyclone coming in. This area is called the eye of the storm. And then as we go further, you can see what happens next. The cyclone, this is also when it starts to lose its intensity a bit, but starts moving towards Junagadh. And the entire area where the winds are blowing, those will be pretty fast-paced winds. Obviously, the closer you are to the eye of the storm, the faster the winds, but there'll be winds, there'll be rain going in through the night. This is 3 a.m., 4 a.m., 7 a.m., moves further in now towards Jamnagar, towards Gandhidham, in the direction of Ahmedabad, and then it kind of slows down. You know, as it moves in further, loses its intensity, and then you can see here, by about midday, the cyclone is much weaker. So we'll keep tracking this all night and then early in the morning. Thank you for joining in. Thank you for your time and your trust. Stay safe, stay well. See you tomorrow.